Are they hiding in coffins? Are they dancing in mausoleums? Or maybe they're reading books in the forest? Where have all the gods YouTubers gone? Hello spooky bats and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me yet, my name is Orkvia, I am a god YouTuber from Belgium. Ever since I started making videos on YouTube, there have always been other god YouTubers around. Some of them were bigger channels, some of them were smaller channels. However, these past few years I've seen a massive decline in YouTube channels that are about the god subculture, the god scene, etc. And this actually really hit me only recently when I was trying to find some videos by YouTubers that I really enjoyed watching and their channels were completely empty. So I'm not sure what has been going on with their channels. So if you know of any active YouTube channels about the god subculture that you enjoy watching, feel free to let me know down below. I of course know about Toxic Tears, who hasn't really been active recently. It's Black Friday, who is making her comeback but has a family now, so I'm not sure how frequently she will upload. Anyhow, so those are the YouTube channels, god YouTube channels that I currently know that are still around. There's also Rachel Mortician that I really enjoy. But other than that, I don't know of any other god YouTube channels. And I know that this video comes after a month of me not making videos, which has a few reasons. One of them is both my grandmas passed away in a really short period of time. There were fights in the family. I was going back into burnout depression because of my job. But now I really am trying to get things back on track again, and I really want to make weekly videos for you. Ever since I have been active on YouTube, a lot of channels have come and gone. And I think it's a very unfortunate thing that some channels actually take offline all of their content, because there have been some really good creators out there that have just stopped making content. Now, I am aware that making content around solely the god subculture can be a very small niche, and that some people don't find a lot of things to talk about. I, however, today made a list of video topics and things I want to talk about, and I have over 300 video ideas. So for me, talking about my passion, which is the god subculture, is something that comes very naturally and that I love doing. There's so many aspects to it, but the main thing that connects us all is the music. And I know that YouTube has made it very hard for us to talk about the music that we love so much. I don't know why they do this, but they have been having copyright claims, videos blocked because it contains some music, etc. So it is very hard to make content solely around the god's music. And even if you talk about music, you get a lot of backlash about it. I have made a series in the past which was called What is God?, in which I talked about different types of god niches within the sub-niche that exist. A lot of those videos have been taken online or have been blocked by YouTube because I included snippets of music that fits with the genres of god. So some of the music has been taken out, some of the videos have been blocked, I had to re-upload a bunch of them. So I know it is very discouraging if you're trying to make that type of content, and that's also the reason why I stopped doing that series of content, because I really think that we should be able to talk about the music more. However, the platform that we do it on doesn't always allow it. That being said, I know that people also grow out of god. Some people just don't feel like they connect with the subculture anymore. Also, we have busy lives. I know that at the time that I started making videos, I was still in school, so I had quite a lot of spare time. I only had to make sure that I was in my classes, did my exams, succeeded them, and then continued on to the next year. However, ever since I graduated from school, I have a lot more responsibilities. I have a job that I have to do to have an income. I have a household, a house that I need to maintain. I have a partner, two cats. And I can imagine if on top of that you also have a kid, that your YouTube channel is really not what matters most. And I get it, it's just very, very unfortunate. Riri Phillips used to be one of my favorite god YouTubers to watch. Unfortunately, due to a lot of circumstances, she stopped making videos. And it's okay, I get it. But I feel like recently the only things you can still find about the god subculture on YouTube is halls, lookbooks, fashion. The God subculture is not just about that. I know that from the outside it can seem like the God subculture is only a fashion-based lifestyle or subculture, but it's definitely not. The music is what matters most, and I want to quickly compare. When Riri Phillips used to do lookbooks, she always would include local bands, local projects that she really enjoyed. Nowadays, if I see lookbooks, it's commercial music or music that doesn't have copyright infringement. And I think that's a really big shame, and I can see this on my own channel as well. I have a few older videos on which I do lookbooks onto music that I at the time super enjoyed. I cannot monetize those videos, and if you want to have YouTube as your job, you have to be able to monetize at least some of your videos. And also some of the videos have been taken down, a few of my dance videos as well. So I know why people don't make content with music anymore, but it's still a shame. On top of that, creating videos demands quite a lot of effort. If you want to do your videos in a certain way, you have to plan them, you have to make a script for them, know where you're gonna film, what you're gonna wear, what you're gonna say, you have to have your camera set up, the lights, etc. So it is more than just getting a camera in front of you and pressing record and uploading that to YouTube. No, after recording the video also comes the editing, making a thumbnail, actually uploading it to YouTube. So I understand that making videos actually is quite a bit of effort. I know, because I try and make videos every week for two channels. And I have been making videos for three channels at one point at the same time, and it was exhausting on top of my full-time job and everything else going on. So know if you want to start the channel that yes, it will be quite a lot of work to actually create the quality content that you want to make. Or if you just want to do a ranty type video where you just sit down and talk like this video more or less is, I understand that as well because it is a little less effort. However, if you want to put in some zoom ins, zoom out, have some text appear on screen, have examples on screen, then that will take more editing effort. So making your actual videos I know takes a lot of time, and not everyone has that time. Now, we also need to take into account that YouTube has not always been a positive place and still isn't. I still get on a almost daily basis hate comments, negative comments, really bullying type comments. And if you have been around on my channel, you know what my policy is. It is to simply block, delete. So I will block the person, delete the comment. That is what I always do, because I want to keep my YouTube channel a safe space. It is my online space, so I get to do with it whatever I want, basically. Not 100%, but you get what I mean, or I hope you get it. But I know also within the God scene there is a lot of drama, there is a lot of underlying communities that think that some things are God and some aren't. There's a lot of these elitists, as we like to call them, who still think that I'm not God and they can do whatever. I honestly don't care. I listen to so many genres of music. I just identify as being alternative, as being God, and that's it. If someone else has another opinion about that, that's their own right, but I'm gonna stick with my guns. But I know that a lot of this negativity, a lot of this drama can affect people, and that can also be the cause that they stop making videos. Now, what I really miss on YouTube is, over the years, I've evolved from being a very, very small channel. I only had comments from people who actually knew me, then that grew to a few other people within the God community on YouTube, and I have actually met some people who I still consider some of my best friends through YouTube. Amy Necritique was one of the people that I really loved talking to. We still talk, but not as much as we used to because we do different things now in life. But when we used to still both have our YouTube channels, it was amazing. We did collabs, we did music-related collabs with us, with other people. It was the Name That Tune challenge that I really enjoyed doing. I also had my friend Cindy, who had her channel, who made videos. I met Jossie, who is now one of my close friends through YouTube. That's the reason she moved to Belgium, because we were talking about it. So the thing is, nowadays I feel very disconnected from my scene. There's a few people who regularly comment on my videos who I actually know. I have a few patrons as well, so if you're one of my patrons, know that you make a massive difference for me in knowing that there is someone actually watching and appreciating my content. It's just the community feeling that I used to have, I feel a lot less nowadays. And there's also an overwhelming amount of videos on YouTube, so you can find nearly anything you want to find. And I know not a lot of people are looking for God-themed videos. So what happened to the God YouTubers? Well, some of them moved on and went on to doing other things, but still identify as God or at least alternative. Others are just way too busy with their lives, and even others might not be interested in the God subculture anymore at all. And that's fine. I'm not here to judge people. I'm just here seeing what I see and wanting to talk about it. So this is my first video after coming back from a little short break. Starting now, you will have videos every single week again. If there's anything in particular you would like to see on my channel that is related, of course, to the God subculture, feel free to let me know in a comment down below. Before I end this video, I of course want to thank my patrons, and more specifically my high tier patrons, Anders, Jerry, Jen, JB, Professor Gothic, and Elroy. Thank you so much for supporting my channel. It means the world to me. And of course, if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe to my channel. I make new videos every week and I would love to have you for every single one of them. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon with a new video. Bye!